Hello and welcome to my channel. I am Zodiac Bandit, and last week Critical Role announced that they were going to be animating Campaign 2, and just recently I made a video about moments that I would like to see eventually get animated, but I wasn't too sure if they ever would. But now I'm going to be talking about the moments that I am most excited to see in Campaign 2 that will be getting animated, because these moments have to. Parts of them are, you know, most of them are a big part of the story, so I'm excited to see these get animated. And yeah, let's get right into it and talk about these excellent moments that I'm excited about. It is a similar video to the last video I talked about with animation, but these are moments that I damn well know will be getting animated, and I am most excited to see these ones happen. So yeah, let's get into it. And one last thing before I get properly into the list. Spoilers ahead for basically everything. Campaign 1, Campaign 2. I don't know if I'll be spoiling Campaign 3, but just in case, Campaign 3 spoilers, Legend of Vox Machina Season 1 and 2 spoilers. So don't watch this if you're not caught up with everything, or if you're okay with having stuff being spoiled, come on in. Let's enjoy the video.
It says, an example it is. Molly, in the brief moments of consciousness, what do you want to be your last words?
No!
Wait, can I say, wait?
No.
He's in it? It's done?
This is done.
Did you get a reaction? Do you have anything?
Maybe I can talk to him.
Molly,
mm-hmm.
You have a brief moment as the consciousness and life leaves you. What are your last words?
With blood.
Oh, God.
As it kind of slams into his face, he goes, respect. And then twists the blade.
And just to get this one out of the way, I am excited to see the death of Molly Mock, because it was very emotional while, you know, imagining this moment when it happened. So seeing it being played out in a more visual storytelling medium is going to be fucking insane and incredibly emotional. This character is amazing, and he's going to be there probably for the first season, and this will probably be the season finale, so we're going to probably sit on this death for a little while if that's what they plan to do. So it'll be crazy to see. I can't wait to see it. I know it's going to be very impactful and very awesome and well done. Obviously, everything they've done up to this point is well done, and with one of the most recent things that happened in the current animated series of Vox Machina and how well they handled that, this is going to be fantastic to see, and it's going to be very emotional for a lot of people, including myself. And I can't wait to see it, because it's going to be the beginning of a new thing for another character coming in, and I can't wait to see him animated. And so yeah, overall, this moment has to be something I'm looking forward to because of all the things that it, you know, contributes toward. Literally the tons and tons and tons of things that this contributes towards for the most important section of this story. So I'm very excited to see this happen, because it is a catalyst for a lot of things. So something that I'm really excited for, and it's something they do in Legend of Vox Machina, that is showing extra material as time goes on. So what I mean by this is, say, and this is the part of the list, say when Ford, Jester, and Yasha get kidnapped by Lorenzo, we now get to see their perspective on things in a more true storytelling light. They'll be able to cut back and forth between the Fabulous Four, that's the nickname that the remaining group members get until they go down to the less so thriving three. But we get to now see Ford, Jester, and Yasha's perspective while they're imprisoned, while they're being transported, and I'm super excited to see this. We get to see their perspective of the fight with Lorenzo where Molly Mock dies, because they are in the cages during said fight, and that will be something extremely exciting to see if they choose to do it. I think they should, and if they don't show us that perspective, they will definitely show us more of what they're doing while they're chained up in the basement of Lorenzo's hideout. And I'm extremely excited to see that, because that is a portion of this, the benefit of these animated series. We got to see the more of the Briarwoods backstories in the Legend of Vox Machina, and we're getting to see a lot more of what Anna Ripley's doing in season 2 of Legend of Vox Machina right now. So I'm extremely excited to see stuff like that happen for the Mighty Nein series that's coming out eventually. It sounds like they're still casting for season 3 of Legend of Vox Machina, so this series is probably a way away, But I'm excited for more moments like this. So this is just a general spot for more exposition moments that I'm really excited to see. And at number three on my list here is the most well-executed ambush attack I have ever seen in a D&D campaign fucking ever in my entire life. And that is the ambush on the Tomb Takers in one of the Aeorian ruins. This was the most nasty, vicious, and well-played out ambush ever. It went perfectly, like, and honestly, there's nothing else I can really say. Obviously, Lucien was going to be able to survive it, but taking out three of the five fucking Tomb Takers is insane. But let's not forget the excellent moment that came just before, where Ford and Essek were talking about how the Rangers and Scouts up top had interacted, had seen them, and Ford told them to fucking go for it, to slow them down so everyone could rest a bit more. This was such a perfectly done moment in the campaign because it really set up for them dying, most of the Tomb Takers dying after that, because either it would slow them down, giving them even more time to rest, because they would have to rest, or they would be already used up a ton of their supplies as they came down, and they would be weak, and then these mines would absolutely take them out, and it's perfect. Ford was vicious both before and during the fight, and I cannot wait for this well-executed moment to be animated. Now, this will be seasons down the line. This will be the final season, so it's kind of shitty that it's going to have to wait so long, like easily 3 years before that happens. Not even, probably 4 years before that happens. So this is crazy, and I'm very excited to see this moment because it is easily one of the best ambushes to have ever taken place in a D&D campaign. It's fucking awesome. At number two on my list is Caduceus freeing Yasha from Oban's control. I am so excited to see this entire arc be animated, but this specific fight and moment, I can't wait for. Because not only does Pumat Sol fight here, we also get to see Ford summon a Vrock in a really badass manner. We get to see Caleb absolutely light up the Laughing Hand. We get to see Veth slash Not getting turned against the party and leaving with Oban down the stairs, which is fucking hilarious. And we also get to see Yasha being freed by Caduceus and the Storm Lord being able to communicate with her as she yells and a lightning strikes and the glass shatter behind her. I am so excited for this moment. It is a fucking excellent moment that, you know, the visual that I get in my head from watching it is awesome. And I cannot wait for the amazing animation that I know that we're going to see on display for it. The glass shatter in slow motion to me is going to be one of the coolest things in the entire show, and I simply can't wait for it. I'm so excited for this animated Mighty Nein show. So exciting.
What do you do? Pull the blade back and throw it
into the
it disappears through the smoke.
And at number one, if there is any doubt that I'm a Ford fan, here you go. Ford, casting aside Uchitoa, is easily my favorite moment in all of Campaign 2. Probably my favorite moment all of any Critical Role media so far. I cannot wait for the animation of Ford standing over the lava as he plunges the sword into his chest, challenging his god who is giving him all the powers, and then denying him, and then Ford pulls the sword back out and throws it in the lava and says he doesn't need him anymore. And then eventually we get to see them go get the pieces they need for both the Mithril armor and for fixing the Star Razor, and then for becoming a, you know, paladin slash warlock for the Wild Mother. This is a great moment that leads to a bunch of other awesome things that I'm excited for. So very excited to see this moment, because not only is a Ford one of my favorite characters, it is not one of my favorite character, but it's just a badass moment. Not too often do you get to see players challenge their deity and then it go the way that it needs to, the proper way, without them falling back into that deity's hands to me, this is an amazing moment. Super excited to see it. I already have a really nice visual of how, like, the lava is going to underglow, like, Ford's face in a really cool way, and, like, how, like, the razor, or whatever the sword's name is before he gets the razor's edge. Razor's, what the fuck is that sword called? Star Razor. Goddamn. The eyeball will be moving and looking at him as if that's Ukitoa talking to him, and then he tosses it aside, and, like, the eyeball is, like, deathly staring at him as it goes away. I really am excited for this moment. I can't wait for all of this show to fucking come out, as, to me, that's full circle, not the Legend of Vox Machina show. The Mighty Nein getting animated, and the Mighty Nein is where I started, so that is full circle for me as a fan, so I'm really excited to see it. So yeah, excited to see this moment, because it's badass as fuck. So there you have it, the Mighty Nein moments that I cannot wait to see actually be animated. I'm incredibly excited for all of this, because, yeah, like I said earlier, this is the campaign I started with. Truly, I did actually watch campaign 1 before, but I didn't get interested into it at all. So I ended up getting really interested in campaign 2, falling in love with it, and from there, we're here. Me making a channel basically dedicated to all things Critical Role / D&D. I want to make more D&D stuff. But yeah, I'm excited to see campaign 2 actually get animated. I love it, like I said, and I just am so excited for all of this. I'm going to continuously make videos about this in preparation because I love it, and I'm just super excited. So yeah, felt like sharing my excitement. Let me know what moments you can't wait to see get animated. I'm pretty sure I have a few other ones rattling in my brain that I know someone will comment. So yeah, thanks for watching. See you guys on Friday.